episode of FishPod TV is brought to you by Coastal Wealth, Seamule, world's best fishing carts, Angler Armory, helping you navigate the nautical world, Danco Sports, the largest selection of pliers on the planet, GoPuck, wearable power, Gel Lux, we set the mood and make your shores safer, Gills Apparel, breathe like a fish,
like a phoenix rising from the ashes, FishPod TV returns. We are live and live from the grave. Hey everybody, Jay Smith here with my buddy Paul Fleming as usual.
Yeah, what's going on, bud?
What's up? We got Paul's father, Paul Sr., us today. And we got our own Hans McCain sitting in with us for a little while. And man, we had quite the journey to get here. Sorry about the cancellation on Thursday. That was me. Have you guys ever seen The Walking Dead or pretty much any zombie movie? Yeah. That was me. 24 hours of stomach virus.
I didn't even see you those days, but I could picture it from your text messages.
Oh, yeah.
It was horrible.
Yeah, it was not good. No. I did not do well.
No. Well, between I took the beginning of the week in the ER. And then you took the backside of it.
Well, God, it's the 2 weeks before. So the week before, respiratory infection.
Yep.
Then I got, come to find out, not all hot dogs are the same. Come to find out, there are perpetrators out there.
Yes, there are
quote unquote kosher hot dogs that I don't even think they're from a legit religion. Yeah, they're like a cult hot dog from some Jim Jones or something, or that cult.
It didn't take long.
They're made by jet skiers. Oh,
that's probably it.
It could be.
It's a conspiracy against us. It's the Illuminati. They're trying to get us. But I have recovered. Paul recovered. God, you even made it in the hospital for yours.
I did. I did. Yeah, it was pretty bad. I couldn't walk from one side of the factory to the other without feeling like I was going to die.
I had one point where I literally thought I was The Walking Dead. I could only shuffle.
Well, I literally was The Walking Dead because I couldn't. I mean, I just about died right there trying to walk across the factory. So
anyways, we're back. We're back. We're alive. You can't beat us. We're like the Terminator. We just keep on going. We may not look as good when we get there, but we make it.
Yeah. we had fun last week at the Miami Boat Show.
Yep, that was a blast. I had a good time there.
Guys, we apologize. We had some glitches. We've got a little thing going on with Facebook for some reason.
Facebook is against us. I think they're Illuminati.
It's not embedding properly.
Somebody needs to call Alex Jones.
They all jet ski. That's it.
And figure this out because it's like a Tower 7 conspiracy. I don't know what's going on here, but we're going to figure it out.
All of our interviews and stuff that we did
live. You
see
how Paul tried to glaze right over that?
I'm just trying to get over it. No, but all those are going to be up on our YouTube channel. So we're going to have all those up there.
Yeah, we're going to get those edited up and get a whole piece. I barely was able to get everything edited for this show because we just how everything went. But we're back. And while we were in Miami, we were lucky enough to hook up with one of Miami's best urban fishing guides, Hai Truong.
Yep.
And
what an outstanding guy.
Yeah, what a cool dude.
He was just so fun to hang out with all day. Mm-hmm. And, you know, even at lunch, he's just a really good guy, really down to earth.
Yep. And we talked about all kinds of stuff. And, you know, when we got there, I expected him to go out, show us fishing. But he really, I'm pretty much an expert on peacock bass now. I don't know if anybody knows, but I could probably take you out and catch you a few because Hai told me much.
Are you paying attention, Hai? Yeah. You see what you started?
He shouldn't have let all that info out. It was pretty cool, man. Like, you get there and it gets you to this spot or whatever and you find the fish and you go out. Now, I guess it's different during different parts of the year, of course, but it was the pre-spawn.
Yep.
And
they were getting ready to bed up.
And yeah. So, and I guess at that point, now Hai's telling this way better than I'll ever do it, you know, but you know, pre-spawn, they don't really want to eat too much.
Yeah.
So it's kind of tricky to get them to bite. And I kept having to take my bait and, like, drop it on the head of the one they want until you aggravate them enough. They just keep on coming up and then puffing it out of the way.
Yeah, well, they'll pick it up and move it off the bed.
Yeah, what the you know? What was
well,
with
they're,
that?
Well, they're being protective of
real
the bed.
Real gentle, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they just pick it up and they place it out there. And
well, they know they want to eat it later. Yeah. Like, they don't want to kill it right now.
Yeah. I don't know what was up with all that, but... you know, I just want to say clearly my angling skills really shone through that day. You know?
Oh, here it goes. Huh? Here it goes. You know, I should have brought my wading boots.
Yeah, it's going to get
I should have brought the wading boots.
You know, it may have ruined peacock bass fishing for me. Caught a trophy bass my first time around. Yeah, I will say, though, Hans's, not bad. Close second.
No, because I'd like to say, I know you said it was because you wanted me to film you guys catching fish that you put me out there first, but I know him. It was because you wanted to see me lose one. You totally wanted to see me lose one. But because of Hai and the knowledge and what he told me to do, I did exactly what he said.
It was kind of hard to go wrong with him standing. He even told you when to strike. Yeah,
oh, yeah.
Do it now.
Yeah, he's going to pull it down. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you go this way. Yeah, yeah. It was perfect. Yeah.
Well, his knowledge is just unbelievable. Mm-hmm. He really has that species in that area dialed in.
Yeah. It was pretty cool doing the whole – just coming up, checking out the spot. See if there. What was funny is I don't know about you, but I know every fish I saw out there. I was like, "There's one." He's like, "That's not.
No. That's not. No, that's a cichlid."
It's
you
like,
know?
Patience. No, there's one's right there. Look at that one. It's orange.
We started off. We actually saw that there was a really big largemouth bass that we originally saw when we first walked
that's
up.
The one
we was
trying to put a six pounder.
Yeah,
I would have taken that one.
Yeah, we were trying to get him, but he ended up going into the deep water and never popped back out. Yeah.
And then when you get up there, and then there's all those peacock bass all there. You don't want to.
Yeah.
We were there for a reason.
We were there for a reason, yeah.
But, that was pretty cool. I have a short video I did. I had to edit it real tight and close and everything. We didn't want to give away any spots.
Yeah.
So it's a short little video. We'll go ahead and show it off here real quick. This is with Hai Truong in Miami. Maybe. Oh, yeah. Did you like the size of that the fish right there? That was mine.
It was a beautiful fish.
There's no getting around it. It was definitely a beautiful fish.
No, that was an awesome time, man. I had a great time. Hey, do we have those pictures ready to go? We'll go ahead and pop up a couple of those. Show off Hans's picture real quick, maybe possible.
Yeah, there it is.
Show off
right
Hans's
there.
Picture.
Yeah. No, that's right, yeah.
Well, that was a good one. I think we got Paul's around here somewhere. Nope, another one of Hans.
No?
No.
It's all right.
It's live.
Oh, there's
live
the beast
and
right
live.
There.
And live.
That is the beast right there. That's Jason's fish.
That's the only one that matters right there.
No, that was a stud. Yeah. It was a stud.
I think he said it was a little bit under a record there. But
it really doesn't do it justice because when he pulled it out and showed you the bulbous head coming down, it was right
there.
There's
Jason's again.
Yeah. Really beautiful.
There's Jason's again.
The colors on them. I elected to go with the smaller rig to catch that because it made it a lot of fun. Yeah. And I think everybody did. We all had a pretty light gig.
It was, yeah.
I used that OS.
You had the O2R rod.
Yeah, that thing was great.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Yeah, you know, you needed your training wheels on. It's all good. We understand.
Yeah. Oh, it's all right. It's all good. You just wait.
So that is Hai Truong. He is an urban fishing guide in Miami. And we actually, I have a podcast up. We did a sit down at the park
Yeah.
After we were done fishing and did about a 20-minute podcast with him and went over some of the stuff, the gear and techniques used for peacock bass fishing.
Yeah, he talked a little bit about different fishing in different times of the year, too.
Mm-hmm. And just about his guide service in general. And Hai is a great guy, man. We instantly all hit it off really good. Yeah. Good dude. He came out to lunch with us. Had a good time.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, if you're in the Miami area, you're planning a trip down there, you definitely need to look him up, HaiTruongFishing.com. Yeah. Look him up on Facebook and on Instagram.
That podcast will be up tonight. We'll post that right after the show here. Yep. So you have that to look forward to as well. That was a really good time with Hai and a good podcast. Very informative. So yep. That was awesome. And that moves us now to the Miami
Boat Show.
National Boat Show.
Yeah.
And we had quite the entourage for that, man.
We did.
I didn't expect it because Coastal Mike came with us. And,
yeah, absolutely.
And so we ended up,
I think we had like 7 or 8 people.
Yeah, we had eight people as we roll up into some of these places.
And it's amazing how you can get in there with a broadcast camera on your
shoulder. I know, right? Everybody's like, oh my goodness, this guy's CNN or something.
We look good, that's for sure.
I did. I know I did.
Had to fight off the crowd.
These shirts.
I know.
Yeah. Ridiculous.
These are the Gills button-down shirts. Gills is obviously one of our sponsors. Mm-hmm. And I tell you, one of the most comfortable button-down shirts I've ever
worn. I hate button-up shirts.
Yeah, you don't wear them.
I'm a t-shirt, shorts kind of guy. I don't even like to wear shoes. Okay, but that shirt was very comfortable. Wearing a backpack half the day, and of course, in the heat, you're going to sweat.
Yep.
You take off that backpack, what was it, a minute?
Yeah,
and
a minute or two,
and
you were completely dry.
I was completely dry by the time I loaded up the camera and put the backpack back.
Yeah, so
I went to open a bottle of water, and I shot a bunch of it over, and it literally beat it up.
It
fell right off. I mean, it didn't even get wet.
Yeah, so Gills Apparel, thank them again.
Absolutely.
Kent hooked us up big time on these.
And
great shirt. There. And like I said, man, I never wear button-up shirts, but I'll wear that shirt all the time. That was pretty awesome. So we went to the boat show. We start off the day. Everything was going pretty good. We did run into some serious technical difficulty.
Yep.
And one thing that was technical, I did not expect there to be that many people, man.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of people there.
Man. That was impressive. That was one of the biggest boat shows I think I've ever been to.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of people there. Believe it or not, there's more people in Fort Lauderdale.
That's absolutely what your dad was saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't ever been to that one.
That's tremendous.
Is that still coming up this year?
I think it's just in November, beginning of November, because I normally go to that before I go to my hunting trips. But this year I missed it because we had left in October. But it's an amazing show.
Even bigger. I can't even imagine. A lot more vendors. I can't even imagine that. It took all day just to get through most of the stuff there. I don't even think we saw everything at that.
No, not even close.
Well, at the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show, once you pay your ticket, you get into the convention center. And then once you do everything in the convention center, they load you up on the buses and they take you to Bahia Mar, where they have all the, just very similar to what we had in Miami, all the big tents and vendors and a lot of the big boats and everything. And then they also have over on the seawall by Bahia Mar, right near the bridge, they have all the big yachts and stuff that you go. There's like 3 or 4 locations, and they just bus you everywhere.
Yeah. At this one, at the Miami show, they had a ton of boats. This was no slouch. I mean, there was definitely a lot to see, a lot to take in. I almost wish that we would have had another day to go ahead, but we were on a tight schedule, so we didn't really get to see the whole thing. So, of course, we've got some chaos going on in the studio right now. We got Paul scurrying around like a chicken going after a treat. Are we good to go ahead and roll one of our first videos, Max, or should I vie for time? Hello?
Boat show was great.
He's rushing, so sometimes he can be cold and callous. He leaves me hanging out in the wind.
Oh, I thought you meant he was in a hurry.
Yeah. Well, you know, we might as well talk a little bit more about the boat show. So, they had some cool gear there, too, and that and unrelated to, well, I guess it is kind of related to boats, and we have it on in the video, too, some of those, the air chairs. What did they call those?
Lazy Cloud.
And you got you a nice pair of shoes that we're going to have a model later.
All right, I'm not going to show them. I'm not going to show them.
The secret, our pretty peacock.
Oh, they're awesome.
Oh, I knew it was coming, man.
Are you back now, Paul?
I'm back.
What's going on?
Amiibo problems.
Amiibo.
We lost power.
No way. What's it say, Art? Go ahead and say it.
Who's the guy on the end with the goofy grin and ugly shoes? Oh,
who was that? Nice.
Who was that?
From my mom.
George. That's from George.
George. Oh, George Landis. I know that guy, dude. Tell him I'm telling him right now. That's the Fleshman's talking.
Yeah.
Put in that. That's the Fleshman's talking.
Inside jokes. All right. So do we have that video?
Yeah, we do. Our first interview we did was with Mark Henderson.
Mm-hmm. From a buddy of yours, right?
He's a great friend of mine. I've known him for several years.
That's why that interview went so good. At this point is when the kosher...
Yes.
This is when the kosher hot dog was wreaking havoc on my insides. So I was off to the side looking like death warmed over. So here's his interview with Mark.
A little bit of a delay here. We had recharged some stuff up, and we kind of took some time to go walk around some of the tents here. I'm actually over here on the docks with my good buddy Mark Henderson.
How you doing, Paul?
Good to see you, man. Good seeing you, man. It's always fun getting together with
you. We've known each other a long time. Fishing's brought us together, and all the boating industry, man, what a fantastic place to be. Couldn't have better weather at the event here, and glad to be here with you guys.
This is definitely a really nice. We've actually had some really great weather. They've been having some nasty weather back home. Well, we're sitting here on the 39 CVV.
Absolutely. The 39 or 390Z. CV, what an amazing boat. We've had a fantastic experience. Got our first one in 1st of July of 16. And, buddy, I got to tell you, it's a fishing machine. Ariel Pared and Ralph and Mo and all the guys at CV, they know exactly what they're doing with the product. And they're fishermen. They understand what fishing's about. And it's been a wonderful experience for us. And, obviously, coming over to the Mercury side of the world has been a great experience.
Yeah, that's
a whole new motor change for you.
A
whole new motor change for me, man. And I got to tell you, I couldn't be more happy with the quad power 350s with Mercury. And it's been an exciting year. We had a good, solid year fishing. Finished second and third in a couple of divisions and was successful in some tournaments. And I tell you, man, the fishability of this product is incredible. They understand live well. They understand water flow. They understand so much about layout. And if you're looking for a fishing product and really in the luxury and just the fit and finish of this boat's amazing, Paul.
Yeah, now you got on your boat, you've got a folding tower, which is good for you because you travel a lot.
That is correct. Yeah, and we also like to do a lot of billfish fishing too. So, you know, the good thing about CV is they're real flexible on how they want to make the product for the fishermen. They want to make sure that format fits exactly what they need, and they did that for us. So, you know, we've made a nice fold down tower that we can trailer up and down the road, and it makes a lot of difference. And you know, so and being able to get up and have that visual from that angle
absolutely.
Makes a lot of difference.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you, I had the pleasure of fishing with Mark in the White Marlin Open, and that was rather interesting trying to stand up on a hard top with the waves rolling trying to spot fish.
But you did it for us, man.
We managed to get it done. But
we had the Fleming stick going,
Fleming
my man.
Stick, that's right. Yes, that's. I almost forgot about the Fleming stick. Yeah. That's kind of hard not to forget.
Yeah, it is. So had caught a big old blue one that day, man, and it was a fun time.
And that it was. Now I tell you, this boat looks absolutely beautiful in the water. We had the pleasure of fishing next to you and catching a bigger fish.
Yes, you did.
In the Nationals, but just the lines in the water, the boat just looks beautiful.
It's the platform is amazing. The lines are fantastic. It's a pretty boat. It's a dry boat. And what they did, they took a lot of time in developing exactly the layout that we were looking for. I mean, a lot of South Florida guys use this boat in their sailfish events and super successful in them. There's a lot of great teams down there. And we felt like it for what we're looking to do and the king mackerel environment and billfish stuff that we're able to do up in North Carolina and traveling the coast. It fit exactly what we need. In our boat, we got five live wells, one forward, three in the transom, and one in the aft portion in the deck. And we got 330 gallons of live well space.
That's a lot of live well space.
568 gallons of fuel. I think we counted up. I think we got over 80 rod holders on the boat. I mean, it's amazing.
Now can you fit a Paul Fleming in the live live well.
I promise you, we can fit the Paul Fleming in the live well and in the live well and the fish box. And
very nice.
We've taken several pictures
We've had some fun. We've had some interesting pictures over the years.
Yes, we have.
Sure.
Be careful with that, Paul. Not too interesting, but it's been fun fishing.
That's
pictures.
Absolutely. Now, how can our followers follow Mark Henderson and the Liquid Fire Fishing Team?
You know, a couple of different ways, several different ways, really. We've got very active social media page on Facebook, obviously. So Facebook.com/liquidfirefishing. On Instagram, it's Instagram.com/liquidfirefishing. And then Twitter, we got a Twitter account as well, which is Twitter.com/fishliquidfire. So it's a little bit of a change up there.
We don't try to
inundate with a lot of photos and information, but we do try to stay very active on it once, maybe twice a day. And we've got a lot of folks that interact, and we'd love for you to jump on, follow us, and real proud of what you guys are doing. I mean, it's awesome that you're here.
This is fun.
New adventure for you, and
absolutely.
It sounds like it's going to be a fantastic adventure. Got a whole crew here, and with your dad, so it's really
That's
good
it.
To see.
Love
Paul
sharing.
And,
I love sharing my fishing adventures.
Yeah,
with my
absolutely.
Father. Of course,
man,
he's the one that got me into.
Absolutely. Well, you know what? You got a good parent and both parents, and it's been fun getting to know you
absolutely.
Over the last 5 years, man. It's
well, guys, make sure you get over, jump in, follow Liquid Fire Fishing Team. Mark, it's always great to see you.
And, buddy, it's fantastic to see you and your whole crew and all the folks out there. Hey, give us a follow. Come enjoy the event. I think you would enjoy it. The CV390Z, fantastic product powered by Quad Mercury 350s, Verados, and, man, we couldn't be happier and just a fantastic crew to work with as the company.
Well, guys, we're going to cut out here. We're going to head inside, and I think we've got a little fishing challenge going on here this afternoon, so stay tuned.
See you, guys.
All right. That was good interview.
That was a great interview with Mark.
You might have a future in this, man. You look pretty good out there, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, he carried your weight a lot, but
he did. Well, he always carries my weight.
You guys know each other a while, huh?
Yeah, we've known each other for several years now.
He seemed like a good dude.
Yeah. Well, the whole family, his whole family, his whole team is great. He fishes with his two sons and his brother-in-law. And then, of course, Audrey, his wife, who kind of anchors down and does a lot of the behind-the-scenes work. So, just a great family. I mean, my dad actually just, on his last road trip, went up to North Carolina and spent dinner with them and hung out with them. So, but I've been all over the place. I've been down to the Keys with them, and we've gone all the way up to the White Marlin Open up in Ocean City, Maryland. And that was a fun trip.
Yeah, I bet.
That was a fun trip.
Seems like it'd be a good time.
That's where the Fleming stick came in that interview was at the White Marlin Open, because we were trying to get this there's probably about a 400-pound blue marlin on a kingfish reel. So they had already weighed like an 800-pound marlin in on the first day, and so we knew there was no reason to kill the fish, but we were at least trying to get the leader touch on it, and we were like 2 feet away from it, from getting a solid leader touch on it. And I'm like, they're like, next time we're just gonna fling you out there, So that's the Fleming stick was born at that moment.
That's funny.
So,
all right. Well, we had, of course, we've already addressed the fact we had some problems with the live stream stuff, being able to watch it the second time and everything, and I blame it on the Illuminati. So, there was also some stuff that was off the live stream.
Yep.
And it's just a little bit of the behind-the-scenes stuff in a couple of the companies that we ran into that were pretty cool that we wanted to talk to and get a couple things from. And then we got that video here.
Hey, everybody. This is Paul Fleming with FishPod Network. We're here at the Miami Boat Show. I'm here with Alex from Lazy Cloud. What's going on, Alex? What kind of product you guys have?
So here at the Boat Show, we're showing our Lazy Cloud inflatable lounge chair. It's a great revolutionary way to hang out, chill, do anything. It's a great product. It can float. You can inflate it anywhere. All you need is a product and basically air.
They look really comfortable.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They sure are. People love it. It's been selling great here at the show. And
that's great.
We're planning on continuing for a while.
How about a little demonstration?
Yeah, of course.
All right. I'm going to hold on to that for a minute.
So, it's going to be a small bag, like this. Open up the mouth as wide as possible.
it in there, Paul. That's all it takes.
All right. Well, this one's getting ready. This one's getting ready to float away here. Well, again, we're here with Alex from Lazy Cloud here at the Miami International Boat Show. Great product. These things are really comfortable.
Yeah.
Really easy to set up.
Super simple. Do they
float on the water?
Yep, they do float on the water. Very stable on the water. You know, you can basically take it anywhere. It's a great product. Very strong. They're available on LazyCloudBed.com. Or here at the boat show if you make it.
All right, well, make sure you get online, check them out, and we'll see you at the next booth.
See ya.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have found myself as a fisherman in the heart of evil. We find ourselves by the jet ski display. Now, I'm sure Sea-Doo is a very great company, and they probably do great things. But everybody knows, if you fish, this is the devil. This is the devil's work here. They don't even know what they're doing right now. Look at them. They're out there all, they just touch it and feeling the power. It's the devil's work right there. There's no other way to explain it. It's evil, and you got to stay away from it. Let me tell you, folks, that right there, it's like as soon as you get on it and you feel the power underneath you, between your legs, they're like a motorcycle. You feel drawn and almost like possessed, if you will. It almost takes a priest to get it out of you. It's like they're magnetically drawn to you, like you got magnets in your fishing boat that draws the jet skis to you. They don't even, it's not even their fault, I think. I don't even think it's really their fault, in a way. They know not what they do. The devil's work, it's Beelzebub's sleigh. The devil's wagon. Disgusting. I'm out of here. Can't handle it.
Folks, this is Dennis McCormick here, and I'm at the Miami Boat Show. We're going to take a minute to tell you a little bit about Tuckett Footwear. Tuckett Footwear is a new technology in drainable boat shoes. Tuckett Footwear developed a boat shoe that drains, has great grip, and dries fast. Let me show you a little bit about the shoe. First of all, the shoe is made to get wet. If you notice, it has drain holes. There are actually 24 drain holes on the shoe. There are 12 on the bottom, and there are 6 on each side. The material that we make the shoe out of is called EVA. EVA is a very cushioning and fast-drying material. The bottom of the shoe, I designed and developed a shoe that would have great grip, and you can tell by design tread in the pod system that the treads are designed to take any angle of force and still have great grip. So if you're on any wet surface, a boat, on wet concrete or marble or a dock or whatever, this shoe is great for it. We find that we have got a lot of customers who are boat dealers, marinas, even people that work in water parks love Tuckett Footwear. To learn more about Tuckett Footwear, go to www.tuckettfootwear.com and get a pair today. Thank you.
So we're now inside the motor tent where we've got all the engine manufacturers out here. We were just out earlier at the Yamaha engine booth and talking with them about some of their new products. They've got the their inside booth pants.
Dude, what?
Follow me over here. We got to check this out. Dude. The guy. What are you doing, dude? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, man.
I thought
that was the devil's machine.
No,
come here. We got to talk about this, man. We got to talk about this. Dude, yeah. Now, what is up with that?
You know, I just got close, and I felt it come into my soul, and like it touched me on the inside, and I lost all control. I'm ashamed.
You know what's going to happen?
I'm ashamed of myself.
You know what's going to happen? You're going to end up starting to read Better Homes and Gardens and listening to Britney Spears.
I think we need an exorcism. Do we have a priest in the house?
We just got that. So you're all witness to it.
Dude.
It almost makes you want to have a man bun and a jet ski, doesn't
I'm
it?
I'm telling you.
Oh, you'll be seeing him later.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure you'll be seeing him. Right. So what was up with you on the jet ski, man?
Nothing, man, nothing, you know. Uh-huh. That's the devil's work.
Yeah.
Devil's chariot.
It sucked you right in, didn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure did. Yeah,
sure did.
But I got out of there. Thank you, Paul. You saved me.
That's all right. I'm here for you, brother.
You know, to go ahead and get away from that subject, those were some fancy shoes there. And
they were.
Very
oh, do I get to show my shoes?
Hans McCain, yep. Can we get a shot of the shoes?
Oh, we can get
no,
a shot.
No, 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 no. Keep them on. You got a peacock. I'm pretty peacock. Come on. Now get up. Kind of hold.
Look at that.
Those. Now that, of you.
Oh, yeah. That is some man. That's some modeling right
What's
there.
What's the name of those again?
Those are the Tucket.
The Tuckets.
Tuckets. Yes, Tucket. And they do work. Mm-hmm. I have been wearing them ever since. Thank you very much, guys.
If they can support him, I guess they can.
Well, yeah. you're taking a hose bath, yeah. And you don't want your feet to get dirty. But then again, you walk away from the hose bath.
You are such a hippie. I swear. You poor, poor, dirty hippie.
Dirty? No, I'm talking about a hose bath.
Well, no, he's a clean hippie.
Your weekly hose bath.
He's a clean hippie. Oh, God.
All right, we'll go ahead and get away from that subject. Good Lord. Well, how's that chair you got? That chair?
Oh, the lazy cloud? Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah. Now, you do have to take... And
effort, I know.
A little bit of effort, but you have to close it each time. That's where you go wrong. You try to just keep scooping air. You have to scoop, close.
I would
have
just ran with it.
I would just say, just run in a circle.
Just run.
You figure on the beach with the wind.
Or if you're in your boat, just gun it for a second.
There you go.
Fill it up.
Huh?
That would work.
You got to work smarter.
Work smarter, not harder. That's it.
That's what I'm talking about.
That's why it's called Lazy Cloud.
Perfect for hippies. Look at
exactly.
That.
Exactly. Huh? Clean hippies.
Clean hippies.
I take that back. I want one. I ain't gonna
lie. No, they look pretty good. They were comfortable when I was doing the interview, man. It was comfortable.
Yeah, I've seen those, and I wanted one. Yeah. But, of course, Hans got one. Mr. Busy Man. It was during... I didn't even get to sit in on that one, because at that point, I was stuck in the portlet.
Which were clean. Very, very clean.
Hey, I will give the boat show this. Those were the most posh portlet trailers.
They were.
Ever in existence. I did not feel uncomfortable.
Which you needed after your hot dog.
Hey, that hot dog made me have a 45 visit in there. So 45 minutes, I missed out. I didn't get a chair. Man. I didn't get a hippie chair or shoes.
You didn't have a marker. You couldn't tag it because you were in Miami.
I couldn't do anything.
Yeah, you didn't get that hot dog at the same place we bought ours, did you?
Yeah, he was two guys in front of us.
Oh, how come his hot dog didn't look the same as ours?
I told you. I bet you it was from that cult that waited for the spaceship and they all wore the same Nikes. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Those crazy bastards. It was probably a leftover from their little suicide party they had.
You should have gotten a funnel cake from the clean hippies.
No, it could have been. That would have been the Jim Jones funnel cake. That's funny. The thing is, don't eat carnival food or event food. It was horrible. But
oh, man.
Anyways.
So I'm watching this live Facebook feed over here, and my brother-in-law just posted the king of foul hooking and then decided to try and call me out.
Uh-oh.
Really? He called me out on foul hooking. I don't foul hook.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure, but I do know that my brother-in-law is the king of catching the cute fish. He is the king. He always catches the smallest fish.
And you always go, oh.
It's so cute. Although I will tell you, he did his very first time out with us, caught a monster redfish. I mean, it was literally just in the slot. But and that was his first, kind of like you got spoiled with your big peacock bass. He got spoiled with that redfish.
Mine was due to pure angling skill and knowledge. With the proper guidance of Hai.
Sorry.
I don't want to take away from Hai because he made it all happen, but I mean, I did get the biggest one. So, if you go back and look at those pictures, clearly I won that.
Oh, yeah.
So, anyways, all right, we're going to go ahead and move on. We also got to stop and talk with one of our sponsors,
Gel Lux.
Yeah.
Love Gel Lux.
It was Zach and what's the other fellow's name?
Nick.
Zach and Nick.
Yep.
So we stopped and talked to them. We got a video here.
Gel Lux, how we doing? Gel Lux is one of the sponsors of FishPod TV. Yes, they're getting ready to pimp out our brand new trailer that we've got in the works. So it's gonna be an awesome trailer build, but. Let's talk about that Intrepid that you guys pimped out. I mean, that thing looked, the new 407,
that
was kind of a cool project to do, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was unreal. It's a beautiful boat. We're happy to be part of it.
Yeah, beautiful lines, and we're
really glad to, like, you know, just top it off. It's like the icing on the cake with the Jellux lights,
yeah,
with the Wi-Fi control system. Make any, you can create any color that you want. You can't really beat it. Yeah. I like it.
Yeah, that that thing is just sick. I mean, the boat itself is sick, but then when you add that lighting to it,
it just tops it off.
It does. It tops it right. And I can speak from personal experience because we installed this system on the Hooked on Old School Fishing team Intrepid, yep, and that thing just turns heads when that thing's lit up.
It just goes with Intrepid. Intrepid's all custom.
It is. It's
all custom build, so we got custom lights on it.
That's it.
And reliability.
That's it.
Jellux, you can't beat reliability when it comes to LEDs. With our LED dock bumper, our bands, our boat kits, everything.
You guys have been having a good show?
Oh, unreal show. Miami's been awesome to us. People down here really love the product line. The colors just pop. It's a Miami product.
It is a Miami product.
Yes, it is.
A little better weather than back home, too, right?
Oh my God, yeah.
New England? Yeah,
what's the temperature there today?
Oh, we got cold. 8 inches of snow the other day. So, yeah. Nice to be down in the 85-degree weather.
Yeah, so all those watching from up north,
yep,
they're in shorts. That's it. Yeah. That's it. Come to Miami.
Miami's where you should be.
That's it. Absolutely. Well, this has been a really great show for us. I'm glad to hear that it was a great show for you.
Definitely.
Sounds like everybody around for today has had a really good show.
Yeah.
So, again, we can't thank you guys enough
much.
For all the
thank
stuff
you,
that
Paul.
You did.
Yeah, it's been a blast.
And we're gonna bring Jason in here. We're gonna close this thing out.
Jellux.
Hey, yeah. Zach, if you're watching, we got to go out for those fish tacos again.
Okay, random.
Wow, all right. Fish tacos.
Just had to throw that out there.
I hope that wasn't like some innuendo.
No. I met him at the.
I know Gators. We're talking about Gators fish tacos. I know.
They're delicious.
They are pretty good. I got to give credit.
Yeah, they do a good fish taco. Yeah.
So anyway, hey, you wouldn't think it. Zach looks all clean cut and everything. That's a savage. Fits right in with us.
Oh yeah,
he
does.
Right?
Yeah, he's great.
A little savage that he is.
Yeah, that's great. I had such a good time doing the install on our boat.
That boat's
which we had some. There was some video.
Looks good,
in
man.
It does. It came out great. I mean, it turns some heads, man.
It makes it an instant party. You're like, what's up?
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, in the functions that it's got. I mean, you can turn the way we set ours up. I've got three different zones, so we can turn one side one color, one side another color, and
so you can make one zone like one like.
Right.
And then the other one, like,
wow. Wow. That just happened?
That just happened.
Oh my
that just
God.
Happened.
That's
Zach,
good one.
Zach, Nick, if you're watching, we definitely need to get those sound effects put in with the lights. So, got to get it going.
That's some Hendrix right there, dude. Yeah. Some dubstep, some Hendrix.
One for Jimmy.
Dude, I'm jiggy with it. I'm down with the new stuff.
We got to get Brittany in there.
I know what the kids are I know what the kids are into, right?
Better Homes and Brittany.
Right? I'm still jiggy with it. Something like that.
Oh, man.
All right. So that brings up. Oh, we had a good time at this. The next video we're at was the progressive game.
Yeah, the progressive fishing game.
Okay. Now, just to go ahead and guide us into this one here. This is a children's game. Okay.
Which was good because we had our two biggest children play it.
So we kind of took over. We booted out all the kids. We're like, "Go, kid!" And then we took over to the seats. We didn't really do that. No children were harmed in the filming this, just in case anybody was thinking that serious. But Coastal Mike sat in with me, and we had a little bit of a fish off. And
we called it the Fish Off 200.
Yep. And not spoiling anything, but it went well for me. So, anyways, let's go ahead.
The superior angling skills again.
There's never any doubt, right? Let's go ahead and cue that one up, and we'll see how I destroyed everything.
The progressive boat. We've got this real fishing game here, and we're getting ready to have the Fish Off 200. We got our own Jason Smith, and we've got Coastal Mike. So here we go. Fish Off begins.
Mike, I'll try to take it easy on you. Clearly, I'm the superior angler here. So, you know, I have my own show. So I'll try and take it easy on him. May the best man win.
All right. Any words for your competitor?
I don't know anything about fishing, not at all.
Never got a thing. All right. So get ready. All right, looks like Mike's got the opportunity first. Oh, you say, still getting to a spot?
That's all right. That's okay.
Oh, look, here he goes. Oh,
All right, fish on the left. Fish on the left. Oh. All right, here they go. Oh, wow. Man, I got to tell you. All right, so right now the score is 740 to 480 over here. So looks like Jason's putting a good whipping on him right now.
I'll even slow down for a minute.
Oh, here it goes. All right, here we go. All right, so our score now is 1,000 to 700. Coastal Mike's starting to pick up some points here. 900 to 1,300. Oh, Jason doing the one-handed wave. Oh. I think Jason's got this one wrapped up.
Oh, cheater.
Cheater. Coastal Mike's trying to cheat over here. Oh. Oh. All right. Well, Coastal Mike's done. And Jason is still racking them up. He's still racking up the points. He lost.
Yeah, I got a
swordfish. He lost his fish. Oh, there. So Jason's got the score of 24.90 right now.
Clearly, I have a tarpon on the other
It looks like it's a bass, but I mean that thing's
it's
a tarpon. Oh, and there it is. There's the release. 2580.
Victory is mine.
I am, yes, superior angler, as I said. But we don't blame Mike for that. He's a superior money man. If you like money, you get a hold of Mike. If you like fishing, you get a hold of me. It's clear.
All right, so what are the words after defeat?
First time I've been inshore fishing in a long time. But
that's not much of an excuse.
I lost.
All right, guys, well, that was it. There was your fish off 200. Clearly the winner was Jason. We'll catch you guys in a little bit.
Was there any question who would be the winner? Come on.
No, Mike.
All right.
All right.
You know, guys, I'm going to tell you something. We need a camera that we can go back to when we're in the middle of these videos because the behind the scenes
I got it.
Are great.
I videoed the whole that whole thing.
Apparently, I was not sitting like a lady and my britches were showing.
Good call, babe. Good call.
Hey, everybody. My britches ain't showing no more. Anyways, that was the total destruction of Coastal Mike.
He's already chiming in on Facebook. He's already chiming
nonsense,
in.
Nonsense. They shut off the game. Stop. Solid excuse. I'm just playing, Mike. That was fun. We had a good time. Even though I kicked butt all over you, it's all good. You know what, I'm saying. So anyways, that was a good time, man.
I had a blast.
Yeah, I had a
blast with that.
A lot of cool stuff there. A lot of cool people. I mean, that was pretty dope. So, let's see. We had the fish game. That was progressive. That's it for our videos tonight. Sweetness. Let's see. Let's recap about Miami, the boat show. There's a bunch of videos that we just didn't have time to show tonight.
Yeah.
All those are going to be posted tonight on the YouTube channel. And we'll be sharing some of those on Facebook and stuff throughout the week. So you'll be able to see all that. There are any in particular that we didn't show that the Yamaha one was pretty
Yamaha
good.
One was pretty good. And David Mueller, he had a lot of really good information about some of the new products that they had. They introduced some new features for fishermen with their joystick Hellmaster system and being able to use the trolling feature and their anchor point where they were able to.
Spoiler alert! Yep. Jeez, go deep.
It's
you about gave away the whole pot. That's
all right. Well, they're gonna watch it anyway.
Spoiler alert! Anyways, we did the Simrad. We talked to those guys. They might as well have been speaking Spanish to me because I'm a kayak guy and I don't ever use those things. So I was nodding like, yes, that's very nice. It's very good. And it was like, bunch of cool stuff over here. And if you knew what I was talking about, you'd probably be smiling right now. But that did not happen. So, So anyways, those will be up here soon. We had a blast at the Miami Boat Show. We will do more. Events like that in the future, but we're going to have our trailer then.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to have the mobile broadcast unit up here in about another month. And so when we do those broadcasts, it'll be a little more solid and actually work.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was kind of hard going through the little mobile system that we were going through. So once we have our whole mobile production studio going through.
It'll make things a lot easier. And
we were moving all day long.
And it was entourage. Really not. Yeah. It was like you would just see this big. I'd look back sometimes and we'd just be like.
All in our same shirts with our.
Yeah. Yeah. The other people are like, what is going on?
All these guys in these blue shirts and earpieces like the Secret Service.
I know. Oh, yeah. If you watch in the very beginning of the behind the scenes part there. You may, at one point, think that there might have been a Sasquatch among us.
he thought he was going to get away from that.
I didn't have time to make the video. I'll bring it up here soon. But that is no Sasquatch. That's Art. That's our buddy that is often mistaken for the Miami Skunk Ape. he is a co-producer, and he has been my longtime bodyguard. Anytime my jokes went a little too far, he kept me from getting my head caved in. So, we got an Art. So, yeah, if you look at the beginning of those videos, you'll see him. He's in the black shirt, and he's got an earpiece in. If you look in some of the videos, he's trying to get out of the way when we're filming, and he just looks like Secret Service, like, the president's over here. We're gonna move over here. President's moving. Let's go.
You're in the shot. Move.
Yeah. Boom. Move. So that was a blast. You know, and back to Hai real quick, too. Hai Truong Fishing. Was really the highlight of my weekend. I mean, the boat show really was. But, it was.
I'm with you on that.
Yeah, definitely. I had such a blast. Weekend. You know what I really want to do? I want to get down there during the summer and try and do the topwater thing, dude.
Yeah,
I think
that would be fun.
You guys did a lot of bass fishing
growing
up, right?
Yeah, we did a lot of bass fishing growing up, man.
We used to do a lot of peacock fishing.
Peacock fishing.
Yeah. We used to fish the Miami Airport lakes, and that was always fun because it was like it was interesting. You get out and go fishing all day, and the biggest thing of the day was, is your truck going to be there when you get back?
And we did get shot at once.
Yeah. What?
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
During the tournament.
Lady tried to run you off while we were peacock bassing with Hai.
Yeah, thanks, Hai. That's right. That little old lady on me over here. I mean, luckily I was on the security team here. Yeah.
You handled it like a pro. It went well.
We're moving the trucks.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry.
I don't know what kind of pull Hai has there, but as soon as she saw him, she was like, all right.
Okay.
Never mind. You're good. So he has a good rapport there. It went over good. She didn't want anybody getting to his spots is what I bet you he paid her to keep his spots safe.
I bet you.
Ingenious,
and
Hai.
The guy at the gate.
I like the way he
did. Oh, yeah. We had to go when we went and got
this
our bait.
This guy's way smarter.
We had to go through like this security gate.
Oh, don't give away all the secrets.
They had to write our plates down and everything.
Nobody's getting there.
He is way more genius than I thought here. He might be part of the Illuminati. Who knows?
I don't know, man.
Hey, let me in. I want in.
I don't know.
I was worried about how fast that old lady could run with that cane in her hand. Though, I gotta tell you.
Oh, man. I know. We ain't going far. We got too much gear with us.
I'm telling you.
Yeah, that was definitely cool. So, you guys were down there. You started this whole mess with him, didn't you, with the bass fishing and all that, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much exclusively. That's all we used to do.
Growing up, you guys. I remember in the podcast there, you were saying you guys used to do some tournament fishing.
We weekend bass anglers. We joined, and we did a lot of tournaments. On the junior angling side and everything else, and then of course.
All right. Please don't ever do that again.
The hot mic.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
So anyway, we used to go out and fish. I think the tournaments I had the most fun at was our 2-day tournaments. We used to go up places like Buckhead Ridge up in Lake Okeechobee, north side of the lake, and you go to these fish camps and hang out for the weekend. And
that sounds cool.
Yeah, it's just fun.
Yeah, you guys get. You was talking about the Everglades a little bit and all that. Get back in there sometimes.
Oh yeah, we used to go back. A couple buddies of mine used to go up, got a fish camp back in the sticks, and go out there and have just a lot of fun.
That's gotta be unreal. I don't know how you guys pulled it off with back in the day without the good sun or not. Well,
the electronics,
sunset, but I mean the bug repellent, man. Back then it was aching. You pretty much had to put kerosene on your face to get there.
Yeah, pretty much.
Skin so soft. Used to work real good back then.
Yeah,
for sure.
Not so much anymore.
Yeah. You smell real pretty, but kept the bugs away.
Now we use Sunset, and it works great. So we're on the way there to better times. Yeah?
Ty Colby said he caught a big red grouper and some amberjacks, and he wants to feed all of us.
Oh, Ty Colby with the offshore bite. What do you catch again?
Big red
big red grouper.
And amberjack.
And amberjack, and he's going to feed us. This is why we like Ty.
Absolutely.
Oh, he's not. Oh, you got me. No. Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, well, he was just telling us what he caught, but we expect you to feed us.
Yes. That's for sure.
He's over there like, no, you. That's a lot of people. No. You know what, though? He came over and, what was that? That was amberjack that day we had here, right?
Yeah, I think it was. Yeah.
He cooked some.
No, it was cobia. You guys had cobia.
Oh, it was cobia. That's right. Oh, my God, man. He can cook, dude. Yeah. If we can talk him into doing that. Ooh, man, we can get a cooking piece on here one of these days.
There you go. Well, speaking of cooking pieces, we've got...
Segway, and I wasn't even trying.
Wasn't even trying that.
Natural.
Ty Roth, who's a good buddy of mine as well, he's got his podcast he started up called Fat Guy Food Buzz, and he's actually got some of our equipment, and he's been out the last couple weekends getting some content and everything else, and I think he went to a food truck rally last week while we were in Miami, and
hopefully he didn't get a kosher dog.
Yeah, for real. So, but yeah, he's gonna
ruin you, Ty.
He's got that going on. We're gonna have him in next week.
Yep.
So.
And Ty did a couple interviews for us at the Johnny Keller.
Yeah.
He did really good. Yeah. So,
Ty's going to be doing a lot more of the interviews with us, and I think we're going to probably hook up with him and have some links to his podcast on
Maybe
our website.
Maybe we can do a crossover podcast. We'll do a food podcast one day. That'd be cool, huh?
Well, you know, and
we'll get the other Ty to bring his grouper over.
There you go. Nice. Well, one of the things that Ty actually really wanted to do is you know, when we do these live events, these tournaments and stuff like that, being able to go after the fact and hit a food podcast right after the show. So we've got all the equipment there ready to go.
Yeah.
So
yeah, and I don't know if you noticed, but I like to eat, so that'll be good, man. He's a good dude, so I look forward to all that stuff. Let's see what else. Don't forget to check out our other sponsor, C-Mule. Go to their website. They are the carts are pretty much here, I think.
And the carts are here.
You can go see all the accessories and carts and the weigh cart. I'm getting the weigh cart. I don't know about you guys.
I want the float cart.
Yeah, the weigh cart.
That's the weigh cart, yeah.
My birthday's coming up. I'm going to have to give you the link, honey.
Dropping the hints.
Talk
dropping
about
the hints.
Segue like a natural.
That's it right there. Huh? Dropping the hints.
See? That apple did not fall so far from
the
day.
No, it didn't. Huh? No, see?
Like a natural. So go to cmule.com. They got, kill bags and pliers. Yep. They got everything. So check out cmule.com. I also want to remind you that Hai Truong's podcast with me will be up right after the show. It's actually already on YouTube. I just have to post it everywhere else. So, and that's a real good one. It's informative. He's a great dude. Make sure you check him out at HaiTruongFishing.com.
Yep.
And also on Instagram. His feed's pretty cool, man. He's got a lot of great catches
Facebook.
On there. And
he's got a good Facebook page, too.
So follow him on his social media. You'll enjoy it. That's a good one to follow.
Yeah, for sure.
You hate to follow the ones that end up half sunsets.
Yeah.
I don't think I saw any sunsets on Trunk. So.
No, that's it.
Yeah, that'll be a good one to check out. Let's see. We got – now, tonight is an exception. I was sick. I was at death's door. So we normally do this show on Thursday nights at 8:00. This FishPod TV, Thursday nights at 8:00. We will resume our normal schedule, barring any apocalyptic viruses or Illuminati intrusion. I don't know. I'm stuck on the Illuminati today. I'm sorry, guys. I saw an Alex Jones video earlier. So,
you know, we didn't even have to use the hotline tonight.
Oh, I know. Hello, operator? Hello? That's for when jokes go bad. We'll ask for help. We'll call a real
comedian. Phone a friend.
Yeah. Phone a comedian. Save us. Somebody really funny. All right. So that's it for tonight, folks. I want to thank everybody for checking out tonight. I know it was an off night, Saturday and everything. We will be back at our normal time next Thursday. Anything you need to add?
No. I mean, we're pretty good. Okay. Good having my dad in the studio this weekend.
Yeah, it was. And it was good. Thank you for your hospitality when we were down in Miami. It was a great stay. We had a good time.
See, while you guys were getting sick and you were in the hospital, I was doing laundry before my wife came back from her weekend. So
she
picked a great weekend to go away.
It was probably best.
We had a full house.
It was probably best.
We had a full house.
You know what
sure.
was great? People will walk right in between you when you had the camera and the microphone and everything. But it was great. He put the stop to it. It was like, boom, there would be this instant. You almost taking people's heads off.
For some reason, you were a magnet.
I know.
People
man.
Were bumping into you. You're just standing there.
Standing
people
still,
just
they were
bump
walking
right
into me.
You're the only one.
Anyways, you know, it's. I can't help but be beautiful. They're attracted to me.
I told you I should have brought my Wade boots.
Man. All right, everybody. Next Thursday, 8 o'clock, FishPod TV. We'll see you then.
See you then.
Hey, good night.
This episode of FishPod TV.